4-4 after one. Igalli off to the quick start. Eatonoff, though, give him credit. He came back against the world champion.
Well, and here we see Eatonoff doing the reversal. Gets his arm between Daniel's legs, pulls him forward, and goes right into a gut wrench right away. That is a fantastic attack. Great strategy. Attack your opponent the minute you take them down. Daniel let his guard down, and unfortunately, got hurt by it.
The next 3 minutes will likely decide gold and silver here in the 69-kilogram class. Igalli in the red, Eatonoff in the blue. They are tied at four.
And again, Igalli can't let that bother him. He knows that for the most part of that first period, he set the tone of the match. He was in control. He's got to rethink about those points that Eatonoff had as being a fluke, a mistake.
Igalli on the offensive.
It'll be interesting to see how the referees award those points. No points being scored yet. Igalli again has to get Eatonoff's knee down to the mat. He's very strong here. Fantastic.
Nice turn by Igalli.
Igalli does a gut wrench there. The on-mat official called for one. The side-mat official called for 2 points. And they gave 2 points for Igalli.
6-4 Igalli.
Dave McKay, the coach, feeling that they should have awarded 1 point for the takedown, then 2 points for the gut wrench. The referee saying he did the gut wrench from the standing position. So there's only 2 points awarded.
There was so much action there so quickly. Tough to score. 6-4 Igalli. 2 minutes left in the gold medal match.
Excellent reaction by Igalli. He's got to keep moving, keep moving. Fantastic. Beautiful counterattack.
On the counterattack, he is as good as anyone in the world. We are seeing that here. 7-4 now for Igalli.
And he's got to stay very sharp. He's got to try to score here and make the referees think he's trying to score, try to burn out some of that time on the clock.
Minute 30 left. As in the first period, Igalli off to a great start here in the second.
What he wants to do now is go back to what he was doing before. Nice, confident movement, controlling his opponent, using his hands to control the head, controlling the arms, not allowing Eatonoff to get in deep on his body. If he gets into trouble, he can afford to give up 1 point, but he doesn't want Eatonoff to get in deep to try to score 3 points.
His coach Dave McKay screaming, keep working, keep working. Less than a minute left.
He wants to pull Eatonoff forward here to get him onto his knees. Oh. Eatonoff trying to roll him over there. Not sure what points have been scored there yet. The referees are looking at it.
Nothing posted yet.
Doesn't look like any points are going to be scored there. Again, he's got to keep confident here. Use his hands to hold Eatonoff on the outside. Don't allow him to get in deep.
30 seconds left. This is Igalli's third match today. Can he hold on for gold?
Well, and this is where all those hours of hard training pay off. He's been working the whole, especially the last year since the World Championships for this moment. He's in fantastic shape, best shape of his life. He's not going to let that affect him here.
15 seconds away, 7-4 Igalli over Eatonoff.
Again, he's just got to hold him off here. Don't take any risks.
Coming up on 5 seconds.
Stay in the center. He's got to stay in the center.
Three
of the
gold.
Can't afford to go out of match. Out of bounds.
Ken Hoos.
First gold medal in wrestling. Woo!
The horn goes. Daniel Igalli had a dream. The dream has come true here in Sydney. Gold medal, Canada. Igalli.
Well, and he wrestled such a smart match. Other than that one little part of the second first period where he got those points scored on him, he controlled the match, did what he had to do. Fantastic.
Even though he is from Nigeria, he is such a proud Canadian.
Well, I don't think there's anybody on the Canadian Olympic team more proud to be Canadian than Daniel Igalli.
Look at this.
Wow, paid tribute to his country.
The gold medal sealed with a kiss.
Here we see in the replay, Agali controlling Gidinov, getting the angle on him, pulling him over onto his back. Excellent counterattack. Another attack here, off to the side, trying to get Gidinov's knee to touch the mat to score that point. From another angle here, gets him sideways. This is how he scored his 2 point gut wrench. 2 points there. Excellent, excellent shot. Excellent attack there. And here we see the celebration.
Please stand by for the medal ceremony for freestyle wrestling at 58 kilograms.
Fantastic.
Oh, a great moment for Daniel Agali. Gold medal in the 69 kilogram class. We send it back to Brian Williams in the studio.
Thank you, Bruce. Gold medal for Daniel Agali. I know you're cheering out in Surrey, British Columbia, in the greater Vancouver area. Let me put this into perspective for you. Again, that is the first ever gold medal by a Canadian in Olympic wrestling. There have been many silvers. Guy Cesori, 4 years ago, a silver, 1996 in Atlanta. Jeff Toohey, 1992 in Barcelona. Remember Winnipeg's Bob Molly with a silver medal in 1984 in Los Angeles. Speaking of Los Angeles, 1932 in Los Angeles, Dan McDonald had a silver medal, and the first silver medal ever won by a Canadian, 1928 in Amsterdam, Don Stockton. Now, we are standing by to go back and hear from gold medalist Daniel Agali. As expected, and this is no surprise, Carolyn Brunet will not be talking because she's got another race coming up. She'll team with Karen Furneaux from Waverly, Nova Scotia. So a very busy Sunday afternoon continues here in Australia, about 3:19 local time. We will take a break and head back over to Darling Harbour. Daniel Agali celebrates Canada's first ever gold in wrestling.